Good afternoon. Thanks for joining us on this particular topic of trying to use Apex as a streaming option in Kogni, which is one of the products, data management platform which we're trying to build in Clairvoyant. I'm Shantanu. I'm the director of Clairvoyant, and Vijay is the lead of the big data practice which we're leading from here in Pune. So I think this is pretty much it, right? Everybody had a good lunch? Okay. I'll try to make this talk as exciting as possible so that you don't doze off in between. So the presentation agenda is going to be like, I'll be talking a little bit about data lake needs and the challenges on a general note. We'll have a quick glance on what Kogni is, what it has to offer. We will talk about the need of data streaming. Until now it's kind of pretty evident that all the ecosystem around Hadoop, we are everybody's talking about streaming. Obviously, we also stumbled upon the same use cases, and we were evaluating multiple ways to solve that. Apex kind of came out to be one of the better contenders to do that. So we'll cover that part, how we actually made that switch over there. We'll go take a little bit deeper dive into how we integrated Apex in Kogni and what the future plans. So right from the middle, probably Vijay will take over and explain the integration between Kogni and the Apex pieces. A little bit background about Clairvoyant. We started 4 years back in Phoenix. A couple years back, we set up an operations over here. And we are primarily a big data company, and we are solving multiple problems for many customers across domains, right? I do not definitely want to bore you by telling what problems we solve, but I do want to emphasize that while solving those problems, we kind of found out there is a pattern. For every customer, almost 70 to 80% of the times, the problems were common, right? You're trying to solve the same problems over and over again, which kind of made us think that why don't we start creating a product out of that, right? It's basically the idea is to make our own lives easy, right? That is how generally all the products would evolve. Even if you have heard Amol talk in his keynote, he mentioned about probably past 10 years we have been doing and we have been solving solutions for clients, right? It's more like an ad hoc or solutioning based. While doing that, everybody is trying to gather more and more insight in what exactly they are doing. They are trying to find their core competency, right? By doing work in Clairvoyant, we kind of found out that our core competency lies in architecting the data lakes, because that's what we've been doing, right? Some of the features which we are not really good at, for example, streaming. Our job is to actually go and leverage somebody, somebody like Apex, who have already mastered that thing. There's no need for one particular company or one particular product to solve everything, right? So I think we are getting into that mode of productization, and the entire community in Hadoop is actually coming together and trying to leverage each other's learnings. So that is going to be the basis of this particular talk. It is not about marketing Kogni or marketing Apex or that. That's the thing which I wanted to bring it up first. So let's talk a little about data lakes, right? If you actually have probably read about this, James Dixon, the CTO of Pentaho, this is what he had to say about Data Lake. If you think of a data mart as a store of bottled water, cleansed and packaged and structured for easy consumption, then the data lake is the large body of water in a more natural state. The contents of the data lake stream in from a source to fill the data lake, and various users of the lake can come to examine, dive in, or take more samples, right? So data lake is a central place where we are accumulating a lot of data, irrespective of whether it is a structured or unstructured or semi-structured. We are not trying to fit it into a particular schema. It is as raw as possible, right? So we are moving away from the concept of, you know, defining schema at load as against defining a schema at the read time, right? So that is the power of a data lake, right? But is that enough, right? So there are a few attributes which actually make a data lake an actually usable data lake. It's not just about putting data into one central repository. You know, we always had these kind of solutions, like an enterprise data warehouse or data marts for solving that. How is data lake actually different from that? So if you think about this data democratization, right? Basically, it's like data which is accessible for all, right? That is the main attribute of a data lake. Data discovery. So the data lake should exhibit such properties that you should be able to discover data pretty quickly, right? You should be able to find some patterns around data. You should be able to surface those patterns out and probably project it in a more human readable formats, with reporting tools like Tableau or something like that, right? So in terms of graphs or any pictorial ways. The data lineage is very important, right? While the data actually moves in your data lake, right from the ingestion up till the reporting, it gets transformed in many ways. It gets split, it gets aggregated, it has an ability to collect a lot of metadata around it, and that is the power of that data, right? Data in its raw form is not really gonna be important unless you attach a lot of metadata around it, right? So that will help you give a little bit more insight. And then there are self-service capabilities. You don't wanna go to the development team or the operations team to manage the data lake. A lot of self-services capabilities should be available there. And the metadata management, which I mentioned, right? from a user of a data lake, if you're able to tag a particular piece of data with some metadata, it'll help you analyze the data much more effectively, and it'll also help you get that data or surface data that data onto some reports, right? challenges are pretty generic. Everybody's doing ingestion, right? Whether it's a batch or real-time processing. We have scalability issues, right? That's where basically, kind of Hadoop is coming into picture. A lot of commodity hardware, it's easy to store that data. Failure cases, again, inherently built support from Hadoop. And then there are performance issues, right? More and more, we are talking about getting an insight to the data as fast as possible. Right, those are gone are the days where you are ingesting some data and actually waiting for a day for a query to run, and probably executive management is getting a report out of that. Everybody needs to see that data really, really fast. So those are the few things around that. this is how generally a data lake would look like. We kind of slapped Kogni on top of that. But you can see that it's pretty generic. You have your multiple source systems where you can actually get the data from, whether it's machine data, unstructured, structured, whether it's from RDBMS and all. This is a data lake where you're getting really a raw stream of data, not just stream, but a pipelined data into that. And then we are doing a lot of validations on that. The validations can be, simple things like cleansing of the data, dedupes. there might be some validations on the source itself. So there are a lot of use cases where we thought that before even ingesting a data, we need to go and scrutinize that data to find out whether there is any PII information. So basically, Kogni has those, inspection tools and all, which actually goes to the source. And before even ingesting it says, hey, by the way, I found some table which might have credit card details on that. Do you wanna still ingest it, or you wanna mask it and then ingest it, right? So those kind of preventive measures can be taken. and then there is the consumer side, right? Where these are the dashboards, whether it's a homegrown dashboard using D3JS, or whether it's Zoom data or Tableau. Those are the integration points which we are giving on top of Kogni. And finally, this is the entire data platform, which is, we also offer the managed services portion on top of that, so that, the initial investment to actually analyze a data, get it into a data lake, run some reports. That cost is minimal, and the time to evaluate that is also very less. We are actually talking about 2 to 3 weeks, right from the customer actually shows interest that, okay, here's my data, I want to explore a big data solution, I want to create a big data lake, and I want to surface that information in some way, right? So that is, I think, the power of frameworks. And looks like that's an old slide, but let me just, okay, all right. Okay, so I kind of went through some capabilities of what Kogni does. Data ingestion, inspection, data quality, profiling, security and governance. We kind of went over them a little bit. I do want to emphasize that these are very important. Otherwise, if you don't really follow that, you're not going to create a data lake. You'll end up creating a data swamp. And it's very difficult to get the right data and surface it to actually make sure that it's actually getting useful to make changes to your business, right? The idea is not about just accumulating data in a central place. Finally, it has to work for you, right? We talked about managed services a little, and these are the couple of points where we are trying to say that how Kogni is actually augmenting Hadoop. It basically is giving a layer on top of Hadoop where it becomes easier for an organization to create their custom data sources, ingest their data into the data lakes, run some aggregators on top of that, and surface it on a reporting perspective, right? The value proposition, as I said, it's lower cost, faster time to insight, and secure, and it's governed data. Right? So why I kept on bringing this is, as a company, we invested heavily in finding out what is the best practices around architecting a data lake. Right? We were capable of actually finding out that, okay, streaming is probably not what we should be tackling. There are better ways to do that, right? That's where Apex came in. We said that we need a workflow kind of a pipeline kind of a thing. We did not try to solve that. We used Airflow for that, right? So the overall idea is to make sure that we are actually using each other's products, combining them together, and finally make go to the market much faster and solve the real problem rather than one company trying to solve everything, right? So taking that forward, basically when we are talking about real-time streaming, this was one of the use cases which we obviously had in Kogni. Many of our customers were actually asking for real-time streaming, and that's when we started evaluating multiple things, and then Vijay kind of did a POC around that, tried to integrate Apex. And it is showing pretty promising results. So I'll let Vijay share a little bit more about his learnings over there. Good.
Hello everyone. Hello. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Shantanu. So just to quickly recap, basically we are trying to deal with the data lake challenges, right? So we want to solve the challenges around creating the data lakes and managing the data lakes for our clients. And that's where we came up with this product called Kogni, and it primarily deals with those challenges, right? So as Shantanu mentioned, some of our customers have recently come up with a few use cases which are into real-time streaming domain, right? And that's where we started exploring Apex. Before exploring Apex, we also looked at other options that are available in the open source community world. There are some technologies like Flink, Samza, Apex, and Spark, but I'm sure every one of you know the limitations of one or the other. But we felt that Apex has an edge over the other technologies, and I'll be covering that in the next slide. So as I said, any data lake management platform like Kogni has to deal with abstracting the challenges of creating and managing a data lake, right? And ingestion is one of the critical aspects of those challenges. And streaming actually falls into the ingestion aspect, right? So I just wanted to briefly cover the typical points that one has to take care of in ingestion aspect of the data lake management. So I would broadly categorize the points into two buckets. One is the lifecycle management of the ingestion pipelines, and the second one is the ingestion type itself. So when I say lifecycle management of the ingestion pipelines, it is like being able to define what the pipeline should be and being able to play around it, make changes to the pipeline and then rerun it and those sort of things. And being able to monitor the pipeline while it is getting executed and being able to maintain the state of the pipeline so that in case there are any failures, I should be able to resume from my from that point instead of reprocessing the whole data, right? So those are some aspects of the lifecycle management of ingestion pipelines. And the second category would be the ingestion type itself, right? Whether I want to load the data in batches or I want to do it real time or near real time or something like that. So coming to the ingestion type, that's where we felt that Apex would really make a difference, right? We have been using like Scoop and Spark extensively to do the ingestion, but for addressing the real-time ingestion problem, we tried Apex and it looks promising. So getting into the details of how we are planning to leverage Apex into Kogni, I'd like to speak a few points about why we have chosen Apex, right? So there are some points which have really sounded promising, and I would like to highlight them, right? Again, when it comes to the aspects of streaming, I would again categorize those steps into two categories. Right. One is the common features of streaming, being able to process the data as it is moving from sources to the data lakes, and being able to give the sub-second response time, and being able to dynamically scale and those sort of things, checkpointing and all. Right. These are the common aspects which you will be able to find in most of the similar technologies like Flink or any other technology, SAMSA, right? But there are some differentiators which we felt that Apex has, right? There is especially the operator model. So you have a fine-grained control of your DAG creation with operator model, whereas in other technologies, you don't have that control on the DAG. You just specify that you have some function to be executed and the DAG is internally created. Here, you actually create the DAG and you have more control over it, right? And I'm sure there are efforts going on to change the topology dynamically in the future. So that is something that we felt would definitely make a difference. And another thing is the partitioning scheme and the unification scheme, which sounded unique to Apex. You have that control in Apex, whereas it doesn't seems to be there in other technologies. So as a platform developers, we felt that we should have more control on the streaming technology that we choose than relying on the other, third-party tools. Especially talking about the operator model, as we know, there are multiple operators in the Malhar library. There's a lot of documentation over there. But a few things that I wanted to highlight are the ability to send control from one operator to the other operator in a single window and control the logic of your business. I think that's something really unique about this operator model in Apex, right? That actually gives you a lot of flexibility to control how data should be moved from one stage to another stage. You're not dependent on the core framework's logic, right? And there are features like idempotency support and reconciler support in the operators, which definitely are key differentiators. And there is something called idle time handler. Not sure if that was intentionally added or not, but I felt that would really make a difference in resource utilization, right? Most of the times you have your pipeline running and it may not be processing the data all the time. So your resources are idle and you may want to do something else during that time, right? So I felt that that is really cool. Okay, now coming to how we are planning to use Apex in Kogni, right? You might have seen how things are done in DataTorrent RTS. It could sound a bit similar, but we are not trying to address the same problem, right? Because our core competency is security and data governance in data lakes. And we are trying to make sure that our customers have that facility to create the pipelines using our interfaces, put their own operators. So basically our idea is to create generalized streaming apps and make the configurations available on the screen so that they can just configure the business logic on the screen. And this configuration is captured as JSON and passed to the backend, right? And that actually would spin up the streaming application. So this is how it would actually work. You have the Kogni UI and you have the configuration put on the UI that is passed to the backend as a JSON profile, and Kogni backend will make sure that it is persisted so that it can be edited later. And the config is actually passed to the Airflow, which is a scheduler that we are using as part of Kogni. So Airflow would trigger the application by passing the JSON config, which actually would create the pipeline internally, right? So this is how we are actually planning to leverage Apex internally. And this is where we are actually also thinking of talking to Stram directly to get all the metrics related to the operations and also the data so that we can give some insights into how the pipelines are running. So this could sound similar to what's happening in DataTorrent, but that's how we are planning to leverage it, right? So this is a high-level overview of how the overall architecture would look like, right? So you have the Kogni app on the front end. You define all your pipelines. All the pipelines come to the cluster via a gateway. So you have all the technologies like Scoop, Spark, and Apex being leveraged for various use cases. And you have those jobs running, the ones showed in the red color. And the data which is processed will be sitting in the data storage layer. There are some challenges that we are trying to address, like how to compact the data which is being streamed, which are some querying aspects, but I'll not be talking much on that. So this is how we are actually planning to leverage Apex in Kogni, right? Coming to the Kogni security part of it, as I said, Kogni's core competency is security and data governance. So when it comes to security, one of the points that we had to think over is if we integrate Apex into Kogni, will it really fit into our security model, right? We heavily rely on Kerberos for securing our clusters and our application. So since Apex is natively built for Hadoop and it works with Yarn thoroughly, and Yarn and Hadoop are very much comfortable working with Kerberos and all, so it doesn't become a problem for us to fit Apex into Kogni. And another aspect of security is data inspection. As Shantanu mentioned, when it comes to financial organizations and all, when they want to create a data lake, sensitivity of the data is something that is really critical for them. They don't want any sensitive data to be visible for everyone to see, right? So Kogni helps customers by inspecting the data before ingestion and after ingestion also, right? But what we feel is, if we have data coming in batches and if we try to apply the inspection on the batches, then it would actually take more time to detect any sensitive data, right? So one of the ways that we are planning to leverage Apex is, since it can work in streaming fashion, the moment a file comes into Hadoop, we are planning to create a lighter version of Apex streaming application, which will continuously be monitoring a particular directory. And if there is a new file, then you just inspect that file and spit out the results. So that way we feel that we'll be able to continuously inspect the results or data instead of doing it in batches, which could create a problem, right? So that is another way we are planning to use Apex. So the future plans, as I said, we just did a POC, and we feel that Apex can definitely be used as part of Kogni. So in order to productionize, we want to add generic streaming applications and make them part of the Kogni UI and make them configurable from the UI and make them available in Kogni, right? And another challenge would be, how would the user be able to see what kind of DAG is actually running in the background, right? So that is another thing that we may have to deal with, and that's one of the reasons why I was asking in the other session on how to actually get those metrics from the backend. So probably we'll explore more on that one and see how we can represent it on the UI, or maybe we'll have to partner with Apex. So yeah. So yeah. That's the future plan. So hopefully we'll be able to demo a live working example of how Apex is integrated into Kogni and also have a successful story with a customer, right? Yeah, I think that's it I have to cover. I think we are good with the time as well. So if you have any questions, we'll be happy to answer.